Hello, I'm Stephen Pratchner from the PIX team at Microsoft. This is the fifth in a series of videos introducing you to PIX, the Microsoft game-focused profiling tool for Windows and Xbox games. In this video, I'll walk you through the metrics view in PIX Timing Captures. It's a graphical analysis tool for diagnosing performance issues. We'll look at the metrics view as a developer who owns the physics subsystem in the game would. So, I need to know how often my subsystem was over its performance budget, what caused it, and the general distribution of my subsystem's performance across all frames. The metrics view has this information and more. I can analyze many types of data by using this view. I'll focus on the durations of the PIX events that are related to the physics subsystem that I've defined in my game's code. This is the metrics layout in PIX. I'll start by using the search box in the selector panel on the right to find my physics-related PIX events. I'll then select the checkbox next to each event to add it to the graph and the active metrics panel below the graph. The metrics view graph shows the duration of my physics-related PIX events across the entire capture. The x-axis is time, from the beginning to the end of the capture. The y-axis is the PIX event duration. The minimum value on the y-axis is the shortest duration in the capture. The maximum value of this axis is the longest duration in the capture. Each point in the graph represents the duration of one or more instances of a PIX event at a particular point in time. By hovering over a point, I see a tooltip that displays the value of the event and a set of statistics for the event. This set includes the event's average, minimum, and maximum values across the capture. I'll start my analysis by focusing on the physics update event. It measures the overall time spent in physics for each frame. For my game, I've been assigned a performance budget of 4 milliseconds per frame. First, I need to know how many times throughout the capture the physics subsystem went over its budget. I can easily see this by adding a performance budget line to the graph. I'm going to start by changing the graph units from nanoseconds to milliseconds. They're easier for me to define performance budgets with. Next, I'll select the Budgets tab in the Metric Details panel, and then select the plus sign to define a new budget. I'll give my budget a name, and then set the performance value to 4 milliseconds. PIX has now drawn my budget as a horizontal line across the graph. I'll use the Markers drop-down list to clearly highlight the points that are over budget. The graph shows several of them as points above the budget line. Next, I need to know what happened in the game that caused each point to go over its budget. I'll right-click a point that's over budget, then select Zoom Timeline View to this event. This takes me to the physics event in the timeline that went over budget. In this case, it looks like this frame was over budget because of this stall on my physics thread. Now, switching back to the metrics view, let's look at the physics post-update event, graphed here in blue. For this metric, significant variability appears in its duration. For example, there's an extremely low point here, followed by a high point here. But the details of this variability are hard to see in the current y-axis settings. To change its range, I'll hold down the Shift key and then scroll with my mouse. I'll also turn off the graphing of other events, so it's easier to focus on the physics post-update event. We can now see this variability more clearly. I'm wondering about the distribution of this event's durations across the capture because of this variability. I'll use the histogram control on the right side of the graph to see that there are two groupings of durations. We see this group of relatively short durations here, and this much larger group of longer durations here. Finally, I need to know what's happening in the game that makes these two event groupings different. I'll right-click this grouping of durations, and then select the Go To menu item to switch to the timeline at a point when these durations occurred. I'll do the same thing with this other grouping. I now have two different points of time on the timeline, one representing each grouping. I'll analyze these two points to understand what's different about the two groups. In this video, we've looked at the various features of the metrics view as a developer of a physics subsystem in a game would. We've developed a clear picture of how the physics subsystem performs by setting a performance budget, analyzed the events that exceeded their budget, and looked at the distribution of durations for an event. In my next video, I'll show you how to use PIX to find a memory leak. Thank you for watching.